out for several years win. He's got the capability of winning the title. He's got a sharp right hand. He is not a man who is apt to go out and get it, though. At least he has not in the past. But if the champion Muhammad Ali comes to him, well, we see in Zora Folley, at least in the past, one of the fine counterpunchers in all heavyweight history. He scored 40 knockouts win, and that is more knockouts than the champion has fights. The champion has had only 20 fights. Now, Foley's had 40 knockouts, and many of them came in the first round. And he does pack power in that right hand. Besides that right hand counter, he has a very good left jab and a very fine left hook. What has been against him through the years, according to the expert, is that he has not gone out and won the big one. Now, there'll never be a bigger chance for Zora Folley than there is tonight. And whether or not he can respond to the occasion, the next hour or so is going to tell.
Don, you're right. Nobody doubts his equipment. It's whether his willingness or his ability to use it. But as Chris said, that's Dunphy, Muhammad Ali's trainer, said last night, look, when you're in the ring with a heavyweight, anybody that's 200 pounds, all it takes is one punch. And I, as the trainer and the champion, can't afford to take him any less than the biggest threat we've ever faced. And watching Ali through his training sessions, regardless of what his connections do in arranging fights in the future for him, whether they be in Argentina, Japan, or wherever, he gives me the impression that he trains and anticipates and looks forward to just one fight at a time, and he's in shape for this one.
He's always in shape, Wynn, and people ask me how I would compare Muhammad Ali with great champions of the past like Jack Dempsey and Gene Tunney, Rocky Marciano, and fellows like that. Joe Louis, of course. I don't know. Some of them say, oh, these fellows would knock him out easily. Well, they'd have to hit him first.
Yeah.
Now, whether or not he could knock them out is another question. But for my money, Muhammad Ali, for getting the punch, is the fastest heavyweight champion of all time with his feet and with his hands. Now, whether or not he's got the punch is something else.
Well, he's got the shape. He has, for my money at any rate. And now, as we promised you before, I think we are ready. So let's you and I join now and watch Muhammad Ali as we followed him during his training session. And let's take a look at the films that we shot at that time.
Training headquarters at Madison Square Garden, and the champion arrives. Floats like a butterfly, stings like a bee, but as you'll notice, he responds to an audience. No champion in history has ever been as sensitive to the people around him. He's in shape. At this moment, as we saw him, about 211. Fighting weight, we presume around 204, 205. Others may determine his future in terms of the fights he fights. But we notice that the champion concentrates on the fight of the moment. Very concerned with his condition, dedicated to being in shape. Of course, speed is his forte, and that's what he works on in these workouts. Jimmy Ellis is sparring me. And how about this training routine? I ask the champ, do you ever get tired of all the training?
It's a grind. Training is a grind. This is one reason I'm not here. This is one reason no one can get me to train hard and do a lot of road work. It's going to bring this distance. That's the way with all the boxers trying to.
And now the sparring session. He and Jimmy Ellis, who were beyond the card earlier fighting Johnny Pearsall, grew up together in Louisville. They know one another. Ellis, as you will see, is fast in his own right. The champion, wearing the protective headgear and the abdominal protector too, constantly works on the shiftiness, his speed in and out, the float concept, and occasionally the sting. Either one tries to hurt each other.
going to be a lot of changes, strategy, and you'll see it in the coming fight.
Right. Thank you, Angelo Dundee. Finally, after the workout, we got a chance to talk to the champion himself. Champ, what do you anticipate from Foley?
Well, I'll know in a few minutes. I expect him to be a good boxer. I know he's punching good with both hands. He's hitting hard with both hands. He's not too fast on his feet, but he's clever, he's smart.
He has had a number of knockouts to his credit, and you've never really been tagged. Do you have any special defense for him?
Well, I've never really been tagged, and many people say they don't know what will happen if I can take a punch or not. And I'd like to say to those people that I plan to never let you know if I can take a punch, because I never planned to be really hit. And the sign, the name of the game is hitting and not being hit, and I would like to retire being the owner's fighter, that they could say that I never got hit. But I'll be moving fast and building up points, and if I see a knockout, I'll try to get it.
In previous fights, some of them have been float, others have been sting. Are you trying to tell us this one is going to be punch?
No, I'm not a puncher. I don't hit too hard. I just keep my face smooth and dance and move fast and do all the hitting, but I never get hit. And then when I do hit, I don't hit that fast. But if a knockout do come, it could come. I knocked out Cleveland Williams, and I knocked out Archie Moore, and I knocked out Brian London, and some fall and some don't. In other words, different strokes for different folks.
When you step into the ring here at Madison Square Garden tonight, will you have any special feelings?
Well, this was my main goal, being the champion and fighting in the garden, but I've excelled so greatly in sports until this is just another arena as far as I'm concerned. I've been on the satellite Houston Astrodome. I've drawn the biggest crowds in fighting history. I've taken boxing to countries such as Egypt and Sudan, Arabia, and Scotland and Holland, places that never followed boxing from this country. And the things that I have to my credit have become so great until this is just another evening here. But I do believe it will be a special occasion in a few minutes when the people in the Madison Square Garden see the Muhammad Ali come into the garden. This is the first heavyweight title fight that's been in the garden in 15 years, I think. This is a big boost for the garden.
As it must to all men, and as it eventually will happen to you, should you be defeated.
Retire tonight.
Unalterably, that is a decision.
Retire. I've said it once and I'll say it again.
Is there any contract for return bout?
Never return clauses in my bout. I'm a real fighting champion. I'm the first real fighting champion. No return clauses and giving every contender a chance to make some money.
Well, your last thoughts.
Just ready to go out. Tired of talking. Ready to go out and defend the title. Everybody got it waiting on.
Thanks, champ. And so that was the champion, a man of many moves.